guys, welcome back to the Kit and Krysta show. I have a stack of very special things.
I'm looking nervously.
Yes.
This is it. I'm so happy.
You finally fulfilled a dream of yours that you've been pining after for years.
Short story, about 15 years ago, I sold off my collection of classic Nintendo powers, immediately regretted it.
Yeah.
Felt the pain, blamed myself. But yeah. I said, you know, I was like, you know what? I should just get these again. So I got on eBay and I bought a whole bunch back.
Yes.
And I have been going through these. It has been a joyous thing to do.
Yeah. And yeah, you had a very momentous core memory unlocked childhood moment as you went through these.
And today we're gonna be doing top 10 mind-blowing things from classic Nintendo powers. Because you know what? Nintendo powers have been gone for a long time. It is old.
Just
look at
like
this.
You.
Look
it
at
is
this.
Old.
July/August 1989.
Yeah.
Wow. So a lot of people may not know what Nintendo Power even is.
Exactly.
Today it's a podcast, but yeah, we're going to show you the crash course today.
The crash course is happening. And these are the good issues, as in these are the, you know, first.
Oh, this is hand selected by yours truly, so you know it's good.
The good issues.
Let's get into the list. What's number one?
Number one is bad cover art, and there's some good examples of bad cover art.
The first issue of Nintendo Power is famous because it's a claymation Mario. It was Super Mario Brothers 2. I don't have that issue yet.
Yeah.
I got that's one on my list
to get
next.
That's on your list to get.
But look at these. Mega Man 2. There's a weird kind of this troll old man. This is Dr. Wily. He's in some sort of a makeshift.
It looks like something that a child
spaceship
would make in art class.
And then you've got this weird clay, again, more clay. This weird clay Mega
Maybe
Man off in the distance.
In the 80s, the medium of choice was clay.
And then, let me look at this. This is just one of the most historic and momentous games in video game history. And we've got this strange little clay Mario with look at this little fake money.
My favorite part is the clay angry sun.
This is the coins that would have chocolate in it.
It is. It's like the coins you get at Christmas time.
Yeah. And then just one more example, Dr. Mario. I don't know if this is clay or some other weird hand.
This is definitely
some sort of
clay.
And so, you know, I do give them credit for not just using the box art.
The box art.
Or not just for coming up with something
that's creative.
I was gonna
say these days at Nintendo, this would never, ever, ever happen.
Right.
Because they would be so much controlling the IP, as it were.
You got a thumbprint smudge. We can't have that.
The proportions aren't exactly right. I just noticed that Mario in this is holding the crappy coin.
Yes, they carefully put it in his hand.
His little hand.
They do add to so much of the charm
of
these magazines.
It's got this kind of a homemade vibe,
a
crafter's vibe to it.
Right.
Which is weird for a gaming magazine. Yeah. But very sweet.
And it was like this for a couple years. It wasn't until, we got into the SNES days, deep into that they started to have more quote, traditional colors.
This color combination is making me I'm seeing
stars. 1989!
Cool, that is a lot of neon and fluorescence, for sure. Okay,
all right.
Next thing, I'm gonna carefully put those down there.
What's next on our list?
Next on the list is letters.
Letters. All right, so let's start with this. Every issue, they had letters. And they would always spend a couple pages answering letters. And sometimes they would respond, sometimes they would just, show it. It's cool, people write in, show pictures of their family.
This person's at a beautiful, historic landmark.
This person is in Russia.
Yeah.
Okay, this is a double whammy of mind-blowing stuff. All right, let's read this first letter. This is to update you on a couple of my recent Game Boy Tetris scores. On July 8th, I achieved a score of yada yada. Great scores. While flying in the Concorde between London and New York.
Okay.
This was my first score in excess of 400,000. In one sense, it will always be one of the, quote, higher Tetris scores ever. And then you look, and it's Apple co-founder Steve Wozniak. It's like, what?
Wow.
And he just happened to be writing into Nintendo Power. Most letters sections are so bland and boring.
Yeah, but yeah, Steve Wozniak holding a Game Boy.
The Nintendo Power letters section was a must read because they would have some crazy
stuff. Celebrity sightings.
Now let's look at this. The Super Theta Chi, I don't know, this is a frat. I'm 20 years old and a member of the Theta Chi fraternity at Eastern Michigan University, and I'm writing to tell you about one of our spring breaks.
Uh-oh.
Is that really good material for Nintendo Power Magazine?
Maybe.
A family-friendly magazine?
Maybe.
But then they just
go on... t-shirt contest?
They just go on to talk about how they went on this road trip and they just played NES the whole time.
That's not the spring break that we
were thinking of. But look at these guys. The wild boys of Theta Chi, yes.
Aw, Theta Chi, they look like a good bunch.
When we arrived, about 14 of our members brothers. We're already there. We ended up spending half our time playing Game Boy in our hotel room. What about the other half? We want to hear about
this
that.
This is like if you join a fraternity, that's what you'd be doing. The other half, though. Was at the beach club.
Where was this? Oh, here we go. This is a good one. The humor in this is that even though the weather was nice and the girls were gorgeous.
Oh, the girls!
We still spent a lot of our vacation playing one.
Oh my
one
god,
bed.
Relatable,
classic.
Right? Relatable.
Now, this. Okay. This is from an issue important. I don't have, but this is legendary.
Yes.
This guy, Andrew from Greensboro, South Carolina.
Andrew, are you still out there?
Is a legend. Contact us, please, Andrew.
Please be on the show.
The world needs to celebrate you. He wrote, let's just read this. I made a rap for you. I hope you and all the NES fans.
That is the greatest pickup line I've ever heard of.
Well, like it. It's The Legend of Zelda, and it's real. Oh, wait, no. You need to beatbox, and I'm gonna do the rap.
Ready?
Yeah. All right. It's The Legend of Zelda, and it's really bad. The creatures in the game are really rad. Dark nuts move very fast, but if you are quick, they will not last. Paul's voice jump super high, but if you watch a speed, you will not die. Whiz rogue too fast, I agree, but if you get touched, you lose a heart of energy.
Break it down.
Good, I'm not done. I'd like to thank Nintendo for all the fun, but I'm sorry to say that my rap is done. That's always the, like, I don't know how to end this. This rap is done.
Yeah, wow. Drop the beats, dropping the beats.
Nailed it. Can we get this on Spotify? Can we get this on TikTok? This is the new trending song.
This is our original EP we're launching right now.
This is the summer jam for 2022 right here.
Zelda rap.
Andrew, you are a legend.
Andrew, you're getting credit for this as well. Wonderful.
All right, on to number three.
Number three, Howard and Nestor.
So next is Howard and Nestor. So every issue had this comic, Howard and Nestor. Now, who are Howard and Nestor, you may ask? Howard is actual Nintendo employee Howard Phillips,
right,
who was kind of at that time like the face of the company.
Yeah.
And he was, you know, notable for, he was like, oh, well, you know, I reviewed this game and I gave this feedback and that's how we got Super Mario Brothers 2 instead of like the Lost Levels. He was kind of like famous for being like the guy in North America. But they made this comic. Nestor is a fictional character. Mm-hmm. In NES, Nestor.
Nestor, yes, of
And they would have these comics that had this really charming art style.
Yeah.
It had a lot of character to it. And they would highlight a different game and kind of give you like a little tip in there as well. Like for this one, it's like Mario 3. It's like, hey, don't fly into the spikes. You can fly, but you don't go too high.
And this was Ninja Turtles.
Yeah, and it was just a really like nice addition against something you didn't get anywhere else.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, Howard left the company around the SNES time.
No,
so
Howard.
It became just the Adventures
of Nestor. Of Nestor. Right? Yeah.
And it lost some of its charm, but these are classics. All right.
Okay.
Next. So every issue of these classic Nintendo Powers had some sort of a crazy giveaway in them. And normally, like,
the grand prize.
These days, like, first of all, Nintendo doesn't do giveaways, period.
No, period.
And if they did, it would be like, hey, here's 100 gold points for your
yeah,
My Nintendo.
Exactly.
But these are crazy. Look
Super
at this.
Super Bowl!
Win a trip to the Super Bowl for four people. Are you joking? It's like, oh my goodness. Oh, there he is, Howard, right there. Howard would often, I want this shirt. I need to get this shirt.
I like how the cartoon version of him looks exactly
yeah,
like him.
They
it's actually
it.
Very, very cute.
And then look at this one. It's like, design your own Game Boy. You do the design on this, you mail it in, and they will make it for you.
Oh my God.
Can you believe that?
Can you believe he actually won that?
Like, one of a kind, have this one of a kind Game Boy? Are you joking?
It's crazy.
Oh, they had another one when the SNES came out. It was like, you can fly to the headquarters in Redmond, Washington, and be one of the first people. We'll give you one of the first, like, that comes off the, like, airplane. Can you believe it?
They should do that again. That would be so much fun.
Like, the world was so different.
Did you enter these contests?
No, I didn't.
You didn't think you ever have a chance of winning, right?
Right, but I was definitely like, wow, that sounds
That's
cool.
That's a real prize, like a really good prize.
Yeah. Like, they were bringing the heat with these
Super Bowl
with these
for
giveaways.
Four?
It's like tens of hundreds of thousands of dollars.
Back
I don't know,
yeah.
Back then.
I mean, now it's like impossible, right? Unless you were like a celebrity.
Wow. All right.
Next? Next, big game maps and guides.
Yes. So, you know, back at the time of Nintendo Power, there was no internet. So it had to be kind
That's
of like...
That's what I'm saying.
It had to be like, you know...
Informational.
It was like Twitter, game facts, Reddit, YouTube.
Yeah, YouTube, all in one.
And so, like, and these games, these NES games were really hard. So you would get these, like, in-depth guides of, like, how to play it. Like, this is Castlevania 3, which is a super hard game.
Look at these maps.
But these maps are painstakingly, like, made. And you can see, they show you, like, where everything is. This Battletoads issue is notorious. They really needed to push Battletoads, clearly, because this is, like, it's like a 40-page guide of how to play
And they were on the cover, too.
And then they did this thing also where for a couple issues, they didn't do a normal issue. They would give you the strategy guide to the big
game.
That's
right. That's right.
So Super Mario Bros. 3.
We definitely passed this one around.
They did one for the original Final Fantasy. They did a couple others. I didn't love these because I wanted the actual magazine.
The articles and all the other stuff in there. Yeah.
Right. And they were only doing these like bi-monthly at the time. So it was really a long wait when they did
this. Yeah. If they only had the strategy guide, you have to wait like another 2 weeks.
You had to wait a long time.
Yeah.
But like...
But again, I needed it.
Like, look at this. And it's got all this incredible artwork and stuff.
I know. It's so crazy.
This is basically the whole game right here. So
look at this. It tells you exactly where to jump.
Yeah. Oh, this is the notorious Battletoads level.
Look at this. The turbo tunnel.
Literally impossible. Guess what? This won't help you at all.
This won't help you because you can't time it right.
It doesn't matter. It's impossible.
Yeah. So it's so crazy.
So the games are really hard, but you did have these very meticulous guides to help you through it.
Yeah. This is exactly what I use the magazines for because, especially for Zelda games, I would have to like 20 minutes, like try to like take notes because I had to give it back to or give it to the next person.
Right.
So,
right.
Oh man.
Next.
Monthly game rankings.
The top 30. And it's just like, here's the top 30 games. They try to explain it on the other page. It's like, we asked players, pros, and dealers.
Who are dealers?
Who are the pros? The dealers are probably like, if you work at like, Toys R Us.
Oh, like,
but who are the pros?
Like
the
retailers.
Did they ask? I bet they asked like the
speedrunners,
the helpline, the Nintendo.
The helpline.
Maybe they asked
that. Oh yeah, you guys.
And you can see how they broke it down, but they have like, and this was really great because again, people were getting into games for the first time,
right?
And it was helpful to just know like, oh, these are the games that I need to get.
Mm-hmm.
If you're just,
I like the very like scientific point system.
Don't get upset by 1 point to Battle of Olympus. That's the one that doesn't belong in here. All these other ones are great. Okay. But they would change these month to month. They would have like a color code for like, hey, this is sticking around for a long time.
Oh.
You're not unseating Super Mario Bros. 3. No, you're not. And then like this game had obviously just come out, so it's like brand new.
The brand new.
Breaking onto the scene. But again, if you didn't know what to play of like, hey, I want to get some older games. I don't know what's good. Like this was where you look.
So this is exposure to a lot of games, big and small.
So something that I give the magazine a lot of credit for is that it didn't just stick to like the big, like, here are all the Nintendo games.
Yeah,
like,
here's
all
the, that's, you know, right.
Here's the hot new thing from Konami or Capcom. Like, it went out of its way to show you stuff that
you might not have
is smaller.
Heard of that, yeah.
And like, here's an example. This is Dino Wars, which is like such a footnote in history. This is
Roller Games.
But look, it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, it's like a 4-page spread with these really detailed maps and strategies. And it's like, nobody's heard of these games. Mm-hmm. Nobody cares.
Yeah,
but
this
like,
one too.
They really went out of their way to try and show you something that maybe you didn't know about.
Yeah.
And my brain had completely just erased that these exist. But then I remember when I was reading this, I was like, oh
cool.
I think I saw this at a store once. Mm-hmm. And it was just like, whoa, we're going back in time.
That is so weird.
So... you know, these days it's like, well, how do I find games that I don't know about? It's like, well, this was actually helping you do that. And then they would have just all these previews of like random games. And sometimes you'd be like, oh, that looks cool. I want to check it out.
I really want to play this game now. you get to kick somebody with roller skates on.
Roller skates and you can
choose. What is that guy in the back doing? Not even on skates.
You choose to be the Hot Flash.
These ladies can leap like Olympic champs.
Great.
Wow.
Sign me up.
Exactly. All right. Okay. Celebrity interviews.
Yes. Also, every issue would have some sort of a celebrity interview for reasons that are sometimes mysterious. Here we have New Kids on the Block.
I love the New Kids on the Block.
And look, there it is. Howard meeting with the New Kids. It's like, these were like the two big celebrities at the time. You had New Kids on the Block and you had Howard Phillips.
He's cute, Howard.
Ooh. Okay.
A little bit cute.
Great. Thanks for the information. But they were talking, I guess they're on tour, they would always talk about how like, oh, you know, I keep this busy celebrity life, but I'm always playing my NES.
Yeah.
Or when the Game Boy came out, they were
on the road and stuff.
That saved our life when we were on the European tour.
Oh my gosh.
And then this one, they talk about they're making a New Kids on the Block game.
Oh.
And how they have complete creative control over it.
Where's the game?
I don't know. I'm actually not sure if that ever came out.
We should go back and check. We should find it.
But some of the people they find, like, they got like Jay Leno for one.
It's like a real, again, like big names.
They got the guy who played Worf on Star Trek: The New Generation. It's like, where are they finding?
Where are they getting these people, and how are they getting them to do this?
But they're always like so like era appropriate. Of like, of course we got the new kids on the block.
Yeah, for like the.
It couldn't be more perfect.
This is perfect. What is this? Volume 20. Yeah. What date was this? It doesn't say, but definitely.
Well, that's all you need to know is a new kids on the block.
Yeah. No kidding. Number nine.
Comics.
Not to be confused with the Nestor.
No, there were more.
Lots of comics.
And actually, in some of the later issues, they would have those like from Japan official like Mario or Metroid comics that are really cool.
Right.
But they would use comics occasionally to like hype up a game against Battletoads. Like, they totally pulled out all the stops and they have
this.
They have just this custom, like, what is this, like 8, 10?
It's really nice.
Something
like full
pages.
Color comic.
It's like solid art, like fully written comic.
Mm-hmm.
And you would just get these occasionally for big games that were, again, a nice change of pace and an interesting way to get people into a game beyond actually showing
them like gameplay or whatever, or like screenshots or whatever.
You just don't see stuff like this unless it's like, oh, we're actually going to be making a graphic novel and selling it.
We're almost to the end of our list here.
Is this number 10?
This is number 10.
Well, guess what? Good news, because I actually have 11.
It's not a hot dozen.
The joke's on you.
It's shy of hot dozen.
It's not a hot dozen.
But we are at number 10, which is retro fashion.
Oh, this is an issue from the late 80s, and we have this wonderful World of Nintendo insert, which is showing you all of the incredible fashions.
I would love to.
Hey, look at this guy's doing a handstand for some reason.
Oh my gosh, this is so awesome.
These children have an umbrella indoors. That's bad luck.
Oh, shouldn't do that.
Oh, there
There's
he is
another
again.
Handstand. Oh, the same person.
This guy's vibing on a power pad.
I would pay big money for that set.
Steal this look of these
that
sweats.
That is in right now. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Look at this. This action.
Oh my gosh. Get patches, watches.
Oh, look at her bed.
This guy's got the whole, this was like the dream right here. Just the fully decked out.
I want that thing. The chest.
Oh, the treasure chest?
The treasure chest.
Oh,
really cool.
It's for the school set, for your birthday party.
Oh, the birthday.
Yeah, the Mario cake.
One of our friends made that cake.
Yeah. And it just goes on and on. And
that bed's cool too.
And it's like, wow, this is the 80s in.
Oh my God, that bed being amazing.
A perfect encapsulation right here.
I want everything.
Wow.
Where can I get some of this stuff, huh?
Like you don't need to. You don't need to watch like an episode of like Perfect Strangers to get the 80s. You just read this.
You just watch.
Just read this.
And where? Read and wear that. Those looks.
Yes.
All right. Your bonus.
Bonus number 11. What is it?
High scores. Aha! I wonder why that's on here.
So again, every issue they would have high scores for current games, and it was cool because again, there was no way to see like, hey, am I really good at
Like,
am I good at NARC? Am I the best NARC in the world?
And
you could compare your scores. And people would, take pictures, like literally take a photo of the TV and mail it in.
Exactly.
And guess who did that and who ended up in the magazine? There it is. Look at me. Kit Ellis of San Mateo, California. Finished.
Look at this. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2.
Yes.
The arcade game. One of your favorite games, I think, of all time.
Finished is always like the cop-out one. It's like, yeah, you finished the game. Big deal. I didn't get 2 million in NARC, unfortunately.
But not a lot of people finished it.
No. But this was cool. I mean, this would, cause people to go back to games or like get in a competition. This served a purpose.
I really want to understand if the people that are in this with you, if they are around still.
Two people from Bath, Maine, who are not related. What are the odds of that?
What are the odds of that? Maybe they're best friends,
How many people live in Bath, Maine?
I imagine they were like best friends and they played this game together and they sent it in together.
All of these people have a story.
Oh, I want you guys, Charlie and Bruce, please tell me you're best friends still. And then we also have two people unrelated from Seattle, Washington.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And two people from West Middlesex, Pennsylvania.
They must have been playing it together.
I think these people are all best friends playing together.
Look at the stories you can make up.
Oh my gosh. I would love to understand if you're, please, I hope that you're out there watching this episode. Please tell me if you're in this magazine. That would be amazing.
So that's the list.
Oh my gosh.
It's incredible.
It is so cool.
My life has improved since I got these magazines. I'm going to continue to treasure them.
Improved from us reading the magazines.
I will not be
you.
Selling these again. Never.
Never again.
Bury me with these magazines.
Wow. <It's> severe. You know, it just makes you think back to how none of this could ever happen now. Mm. You know, and it's like.
Way to be a bummer.
This is a good thing.
Oh.
It's like now you have this like a captured like moment in time.
Oh, sure.
You know, which is really cool. And that's, you know, it's sad a little bit, but it's also like better that you can't replicate so easily because there also won't be as special. So.
Okay. Wow.
Anyways, that's my hot take at the end of this episode.
Bit of wisdom at the end. Wow. Very, life advice.
It's very sage.
Ooh.
Sage.
Time to go meditate,
advice.
I think.
Yeah. Let's put the magazines around us and we can zen. We can have a zen moment with them. Okay. We want to know your experience with Nintendo Power Magazine. If you own them still, if you're in them.
Is this your first time seeing
it? Yeah.
Maybe.
Well, we must be old then. Is your first time seeing this? Tell us. We want to know everything about your history, this was definitely like a part of our childhood. So we want to know if you experienced this too. And if you wrote the rap, please call us. Please, seriously, Andrew, I think that's your name. Please call us. If you're in the high score, if you ever sent in and gotten a trip to the Super Bowl, like please tell us. We want to know all the things. All right, we are
That's
going
it.
To wrap it up for today. We will see you later.
Bye.
Bye.